Click subscribe and bell icon to get regular notifications.
What we do is any when patient comes with some particular symptom, first we do a thorough history taking. That is, what are the symptoms of the patient, what are the problems of the patient. We in detail, step by step, we write down the history, then we do a clinical examination, whether there is any problem in the oral cavity or in the breast or in the abdomen. So we clinically examine the patient in detail. So this is as far as the patient concerned. And then once we have some suspiciousness about the cancer, then we do some tests. So first test most of the time will be the normal sonography or x-ray or some type of scan, where we will see that, or mammography for the breast. So first we will have some vague idea whether there is a lump or tumor, yes or not. Then we confirm it with the FNAC, what is called as fine needle aspiration cytology, or tru-cut biopsy, where we put one needle and we take some tissue or sample from the lump and we send it to the pathology laboratory. So then our pathologist will tell us, looking into the microscope and putting some chemical reagents or stains, whether these are looking like cancerous cell or non-cancerous cell. And then once we diagnose that this is a cancer, then we go for subtypes of the cancer or subclassification of cancer. Then we run a battery of tests called as immunohistochemistry or molecular biology or molecular analysis. So these are different tests we do, and we confirm the type of the cancer also. Then comes very important is the stage of the cancer. So for that stage of the cancer, we sometimes do a CT scan, sometimes MRI, sometimes what is called as PET scan, positron emission tomography scan. This is very, very important scan as far as the cancer treatment is concerned, because in one scan, it gives us idea about the whole cancer process. The tumor is only at the localized place, or it has gone from one organ to other organ, or it has spread to other multiple organs. So in those, that one scan, positron emission tomography scan, where we inject FDG, that is fluorodeoxyglucose, one molecule, and then there's a special camera, a special software, the chemical goes into the body, and wherever there is a high metabolism, because cancer cells are high metabolically, they are very active and the metabolism is very high wherever the cancer cell is. So in a PET scan, we will come to know that is there is only one tumor, or there are multiple tumor, or it has spread to the other organs. So exactly we can assess the extent of the disease with the particularly whole body PET scan. Then sometimes we do endoscopy for upper GI tumors, sometimes colonoscopy for colorectal cancer, and there are few other tests which are as per the requirement for that particular cancer. We do those tests and then we diagnose that this particular patient has this particular cancer and this is the stage of the cancer, because unless until we define the problem, we cannot treat the problem. So now we have come to the conclusion that this patient has this cancer in this stage, and then we will plan the next plan of treatment for that particular patient.